the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everybody. It is really good to be together and to be at prayer with each other as we celebrate the eighth Sunday in Ordinary Time. And we're getting very close to Lent. So this is our last moments to say Alleluia until Christ is risen. Let's begin. Let's first acknowledge our sins so that we can enter into these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty,
O Lord, we pray that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. When a sieve is shaken, the husks appear. So do one's faults when one speaks. As the test of what the potter molds is in the furnace, so in tribulation is the test of the just. The fruit of the tree shows the care that it has had. So too does one's speech disclose the bent of one's mind. Praise no one before he speaks, for it is then that people are tested. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks to you. good to give thanks to the Lord, to make music to your name, O Most High, to proclaim your loving mercy in the morning, and your truth in the watches of the night. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you, to give thanks to you. The just will flourish like the palm tree, and grow like a Lebanon cedar, planted in the house of the Lord. They will flourish in the courts of our God. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you, to give thanks to you. Still bearing fruit when they are old, still full of sap, still green, to proclaim that the Lord is upright. In him, my rod, there is no wrong. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you, to give thanks to you. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you, to give thanks to you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, when this which is corruptible clothes itself with incorruptibility, and this which is mortal clothes itself with immortality, then the word that is written shall come about. Death is swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, be firm, steadfast, always fully devoted to the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told his disciples a parable. Can a blind person guide a blind person? Will not both fall into a pit? No disciple is superior to the teacher, but when fully trained, every disciple will be like his teacher. Why do you notice the splinter in your brother's eye, but do not perceive the wooden beam in your own? How can you say to your brother, "Brother, let me remove that splinter in your eye," when you do not even notice the wooden beam in your own? You hypocrite, remove the wooden beam from your eye first, then you will see clearly to remove the splinter in your brother's eye. A good tree does not bear rotten fruit, nor does a rotten tree bear good fruit. For every tree is known by its own fruit. For people do not pick figs from thorn bushes, nor do they gather grapes from brambles. A good person, out of the store of goodness in his heart, produces good. But an evil person, out of the store of evil, produces evil. For from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Words are very powerful. Words inspire, words can create, words can move people into action and have the power to lift us up. But unfortunately, as we also know, they have the power to tear people down, because words accuse, words incite anger, words move people to hate. And as we've seen this week, in the worst possible way, words can start war. And so our hearts go out to the Ukrainian people right now and those in our parish who are suffering and struggling right now as they face this reality. But we know and believe that words can also be the solution, and words can end war too. Words can move people to seek justice, and words can hopefully eventually get us to peace. Words mean something. And the one who teaches us that in the most profound way, of course, is Jesus. That's because Jesus is the Word of God, you know, capital W, as St. John will point out to us. God creates through his word. He creates through Christ. He said, "Let there be light," and there was. It created the universe. And as St. John tells us, this word became flesh and lived among us to teach us what we know about life and how to live well and how to live in relationship with God and to live in relationship with others. I mention all of this because one of the strong messages of today's readings that's really powerful is that what we say, our own words, often reflect what's revealed within our very heart, in our very soul. So in the first reading, we heard the great thinker, a very wise man, Sirach, say, "The fruits of a tree shows the care it has." So too does one's speech. It discloses the bent of one's mind. Jesus puts it this way today. A good person, out of the store of goodness in his heart, produces good. But an evil person, out of a store of evil, produces evil. For from the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. From the fullness of the heart, the mouth speaks. Those are great words to reflect on, aren't they? Because it leads us, I think, to a question that we need to face. What's stored within our hearts? What motivates us? How do we see the world and how do we see the people within it? What's our heart moving us to do? The spiritual masters would probably put it this way. You know, who or what is at the center of our life You know, can we name it? When Jesus is there, when Jesus is at our center, then our life, our words, our actions, what we do will reveal it. But if Jesus isn't at the center, then something's replacing him. And so then we have to look at our life, do some soul searching. What could that be? Is it power, money, politics, pleasure, control? You know, whatever it is, something would drive our actions and come out in our words. And maybe that's why Jesus has us think about guides and teachers today. You know, who or what ultimately is guiding us? The last 3 weeks, we've been hearing Jesus' sermon on the plain, and that's one of his greatest teachings, of course. And the teaching does resonate with us because we know it so well and we know that there's truth to it. And so it does guide us. Even if we feel we're not quite up to this ideal that Jesus lays out, we know that it's right. We know that it's true. And so it's a message that has great power. Value relationships, value people. And when we do that, we can forgive. He says, don't judge, don't condemn people, be generous, show mercy, love radically, look out for people. What Jesus cautions us today is just being aware that we can be tempted to follow guides that lead us in the opposite direction. They can blind us and they can pull us into darkness, you know, ways of thinking that cloud us or confuse us or disorient us, enough to make something not so good look pretty attractive, which of course is the lure of sin. And that's where the internet really comes into play, because the internet, as we know, is full of words. It's full of guides. So we just have to be aware and critical about what it is we're taking in, because the guides today have websites and Twitter accounts and YouTube videos and Facebook pages and so many things that we can tap into. But God gives us, each of us, minds and hearts that allow us to evaluate, to question, and to decide whether what we're engaged in sounds true. Does it sound right? And we can do that because we do know Christ and we do hold on to his words. We know that his words reveal the truth. So God gave us, each of us, the power to think and to form a conscience based on the words of life that he gives to us. So when we study Christ, when we listen to his word, when we engage in what the church is teaching us, and we allow it to penetrate into our very selves, like we're doing right now as we're anchored on his words, then we develop a critical sense that allows us to reject what's false and follow then what's true. You know, what Jesus reveals to us today is what God is hoping we'll see through him, that people aren't our competitors or our inconveniences to us or objects to disregard or to take advantage of or to get rid of through invasions and the sinfulness of war. People are human beings with life, and every one of us are meant to contribute and to participate and to be valued. We're not meant to destroy one another. We're meant to embrace one another. And the human spirit will always soar inside of these words, Jesus's words, that give us life. And our own words then can reflect it. And so the most powerful thing we can do when we feel hopeless, like now as we watch the horror of war in front of us, is to pray. And that's using the power of our words, because God hears the cry of his people. And as Jesus revealed in his humanity, he even cries with us. Words are powerful and can bring goodness and life and eventually peace into a world that needs it and is longing for it. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things, visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now, as a community of faith and prayer, let us bring our needs to God.
For our church, that we remain a beacon of hope within a darkened world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Ukraine, as they battle invasion and war, that justice will reign with a lasting peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, that we have the courage to perceive and recognize our own weaknesses as we show compassion for others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and injured, that they find healing and comfort, including Sandy Black, Darren D'Abreu, Yoita Abukabel, Kate Eugene, Norbert Cecil, Ursula Ritter, George Noonan, Noreen Gallivan, Bob Gallivan, Beatrice Langendorf, and those you would like to remember, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in faith, that they may dwell in Christ's abundant love, including Lucille Brabeck, Marianne Calderola, for Father Rizzo's sister, Carol Napoleon, and for those you would now like to remember, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the needs that remain silent in our hearts, for the needs of those listed in our book of prayer intentions, and for those for whom we are offering masses for this weekend, Mary Pat McMahon, Thomas Ticini, Joanne Sir Guaco, Loretta Guiney, Carol Horvath, Robert Pinaccio, Michael DeLarco, Irene Jarris, John Soka, Helen Glome, Sam Salvador, Catherine O'Hara, and our St. Hubert parishioners, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we do thank you for always providing for us and for listening to our concerns and the prayers that we bring to you. So please answer them according to your will, because we place them always into your hands through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My heart, oh Lord, take my hopes and dreams, take my heart with all its plans and schemes.
now pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name and count our oblations as signs of our desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant as the source of merit may also help us to attain merit's reward through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It's our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all of the angels and the saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, everyone, for your generosity last weekend, for those of you who are able to participate in the annual Catholic Appeal, and also for all of those who brought food in and gift cards for our monthly food drive, which benefited this time Church of the Holy Spirit. Also, this week, Lent begins. So on Ash Wednesday, we have Masses at 7 a.m., 8:30 a.m. with the school children, and 7:30 p.m. We have services for the distribution of ashes at noon and at 4:30. And then in the afternoon, for those of you who may not feel comfortable coming into a public space just yet, or need to do so for your own personal health situation, we'll be out in the parking lot and by the front entrance between 1:30 and 4 p.m. So we enjoy the opportunity to gather on this important day as we begin Lent. It's always good to be with you and to be together in prayer. And so, may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.